Kitchen Table Consultation, Robbie and Ronnie.
That we're sitting here at your kitchen table.
It is. We always enjoy it, don't we?
We do. We've had some really great conversations. And that's why I wanted to put the camera on now, because we were starting a really great conversation.
We were talking, that's right, we were. So restart.
Restart. Mm-hmm. What was the conversation?
We were talking about the effect of the COVID situation on people and how we all have to adapt and change. It's a much faster evolution than we thought it would be, but it's part of it, I guess. We believe that there's a plan sent to us by God, and He's probably getting a little impatient with us and some of our behaviors. So I think it's a challenge that is worldwide to all peoples everywhere.
Yeah, right? Any language, any color of skin, if you're rich, poor, doesn't matter.
Yes, that's right. It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah. So everyone is affected. Everyone who is in existence on Earth. So.
And all the holy books have said that, too.
They have predicted that tests and difficulties would come. That's right. Unfortunately, that's the only way in general that mankind pays attention, is that if they have to go through something traumatic.
Yeah.
I think it's kind of human nature. If you're warm and comfy and cozy and full, you don't want anything to change. You don't have any desire to change anything. But if you're cold and hungry and have nowhere to live, and if you're ill or your family's a challenged situation, then you want change. Everybody, that's when people pay attention. And I think God is really telling us that it's time to pay attention.
Yeah, it's time to work on the bad habits. You know,
right.
Those habitual behaviors of really unhealthy things and ungodly things for the most part, because we are a wonderful creation of God. And why be disrespectful to God by not treating ourselves well?
That's right.
Keeping
ourselves
healthy,
and each other, yes.
Taking care of each other. But if you can't take care of yourself,
yeah, if you don't,
you're not going to be helpful to anybody.
Yeah.
And that's what I like about the Baha'i prayers, because some of them I'm reading have the word, the prayers better than I do, Ronnie. But about God is a better friend to me than I am to myself.
Correct.
So I thought about that, because that's how we met, kind of in a interesting way, where you said to me, and I quote,
"You're a Baha'i and you don't know it."
That's right. And I was like, what? I know everything, but I what I mean.
I felt
confident because of just the way we had met. It was a very auspicious day and moment. And then you said something that I had no idea.
What I was calling you.
What? And then I said, like, Dizzy Gillespie?
Yes.
And that's what you said. You said other musicians, too. Crosby, Stills, and Nash. Red Grammar. I mean, we know people that are.
Dan Seals. Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of people.
Yeah. So that's my line of work. And I had no idea that that's how God was there. I don't know what I was looking for, but I always walked with steps that I trusted God with. You know, like, I didn't want to take any move or do any action that I didn't think that God would approve,
mm-hmm.
at the very least. Sometimes I'd make a lot of mistakes, but it's not like I wanted to make the mistake, you know.
We all do that. That's why we're human and God's God.
That's right. That's right. What a journey, you know, mm-hmm. since meeting you then,
mm-hmm.
to this moment now.
Yes. We have to change. Each of us in our own life evolves, and this COVID thing is such a challenge. None of us can live exactly how we lived 3-4 months ago. Everything is different to for everybody. Not, it isn't just people who got laid off of work, or it isn't just people who are entertainers, or isn't just people who like to hike and picnic. It's everybody. Everybody is affected somehow. Life, because of that, will be much different, because we thought that things were going onto electronics and internet and stuff before. Well, now we know that we don't have to have huge fancy buildings for our businesses. People can work from their home. All these things are different. It's a changing world, and it's changing pretty fast.
And you know, for me as a musician and a storyteller, I have always known that. I sing songs to children about kindness, love, perseverance. I mean, all of the values and attributes that we hope to attain. And I think that people have had this opportunity during COVID-19 to realize that we have been living such beautiful blessings and so busy doing something, this and this and this and this, that we even forget to say, like, wow. And even if we do, we don't do it 24/7. There's a moment where we're going to do something that we don't even have our mind focused on God. Forgive me for saying we. Maybe it's just me I'm talking about. But there are moments where maybe there's something that I've started to think about. Like, I'm thinking about packing my bags. And that's, like, weird, you know, because, like you said, new things are happening.
Nothing ever stays the same.
Nothing stays the same.
It's just changing faster than it was changing last year. But if you can't go back, we can't go back to,
no,
say, the year 2015 and live it over. Life isn't like that. The world doesn't work that way. You have to start from this day and go forward. So it always leaves room for us to improve. We always, if we've tried something and we thought it was good and it didn't work out the way we thought, doesn't mean quit. It means, okay, look at it again and figure it out and go forward. You can't go backwards.
And that's what's beautiful about being an artist, because that's how an artist operates. You know,
mm-hmm.
It's not something that we're like, oh, when I'm 12, I'm going to be an artist.
Mm-hmm.
You just are born who you are.
Yeah.
And then when you discover that you're an artist, it's the most fascinating thing. You've been hanging out with me this year. And you've been having an artist life experience.
I have been sharing it. That's right.
It was interesting.
I have learned a lot. It's very interesting. Yes.
And it's very free. It's very loving. It's very kind. It's, you know, music.
Mm-hmm.
Music is a blessing.
Yes, it is.
And I've read that in the Baha'i writings about music, art, creativity,
mm-hmm.
drawing, writing, numbers, all of these things are significant.
Yes, they are.
For us to be aware of, like the number 19. But, you know, if you don't know, then you'd never know.
That's right.
So life is like a lifelong experience of learning. We are going to be students until we're not anymore. And then we'll probably still be students.
Yeah. Well, a thought for this this time, and maybe something from the writings of the faith that would kind of relate to this situation, is from Abdu'l-Bahá, who was the exemplar of the Baha'i faith. And in one of his talks, he said, "I charge you all that each one of you concentrate all the thoughts of your heart on love and unity. And when a thought of war comes, oppose it by a stronger thought of peace.
Mm.
A thought of hatred must be destroyed by more powerful thought of love. Thoughts of war bring destruction to all harmony, well-being, restfulness, and content. Thoughts of love are constructive of brotherhood, peace, friendship, and happiness. When the soldiers of the world draw their swords to kill, soldiers of God clasp each other's hands. So may all the savagery of man disappear by the mercy of God, working through the pure in heart and the sincere of soul. Do not think the peace of the world an idea impossible to attain. Nothing is impossible to the divine benevolence of God.
So on that note, we're gonna say thanks for watching this video.
Come talk to us again.
Come
or
talk to
us
again.
Yeah.
And keep in touch with us. If you see this video and you like it, leave a message and just let us know. Bless you.
Take care.
Aloha. And humanity.